That's right. And this all came about after the Georgia Pardons and Parole Board yesterday met for a very lengthy session behind closed doors. They were hearing testimony from both sides, from attorneys representing Davis who were arguing that they had 7 out of 9 of the witnesses who testified against him have since recanted or changed their stories, some claiming that they were intimidated by police into testifying against him. They've also pointed out that they've had people come forward saying that someone else was responsible for this murder. All of that was before the board. Everyone came back from that meeting with the board thinking that they got their point across, that the board was definitely listening, asking a lot of questions about this case. Apparently, they had done their homework and were very, very familiar with this case. So both sides coming out thinking that they had made their case very strongly. Of course, the people who had the last word before that board were the family members of the officer McPhail, who was murdered that night in 1989. They spoke to us after they had spoken to the board, and they said that they wanted justice. They wanted to make sure that this execution went through. They have believed all along in the guilt of Davis. Contrary to what hundreds of thousands of other people have apparently believed, the hundreds of thousands who have signed petitions in support of him, people including former President Jimmy Carter, saying there's too much doubt surrounding this case for this execution to go through. But now the Georgia Board of Pardons and Parole have decided they will not be granting clemency in this case, and Troy Davis will keep his appointment with lethal injection on Georgia's death row tomorrow.